please stand as you are able, as together we confess our faith with the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified.
He has spoken through the prophets.
We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray. As we gather this Sunday, in whatever ways God has blessed us to be able to do, we are mindful that we are brought together with siblings of different nations, races, and languages. May the particularities of these days inform the prayers we offer for the world and for all its inhabitants. We pray for the church global and the ways disciples near and far gather and scatter from Christ's table to be witnesses to love, justice, welcome, healing, and peace. We pray for our collective economic well-being that is built upon the faithfulness of individuals seeking to live out their vocations in ways that fulfill their sense of purpose, while also blessing their households and their communities. We pray for our renewed commitment to justice as our eyes are open to the manifestations of injustice. May we be compelled to recognize the essential value of those we previously failed to see or value at all. May their suffering not only cease to go unnoticed, but may we embrace our call to join in the cause of bringing about God's kingdom. We pray for a perspective of our common stewardship of our earthly home, that we might be awakened to our interdependence with one another and with nature, and our ultimate dependence on you, God. May we recommit ourselves to the stewardship of your creation that has been entrusted to our mutual care. We pray for all those who are in need, who are hurting, who are sick, especially those whose names we offer up either silently or aloud. God, we pray that we might be open to encountering your amazing grace through this sacrament that we are about to eat. May we receive both the power of your love and forgiveness for ourselves and the power to offer that love and forgiveness to all through our relationships. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us turn to one another and share a sign of that peace and that love. You may be seated for the announcements. So, what do we got to celebrate, Tammy?
I don't know, a gold ball that came in?
A gold ball? My goodness. Well, congratulations to Callista, who I'm guessing is sleeping it off, and to Kaylee Taplin, and to all of the girls. What a joyous, hard work. But payoff for their hard work. Other celebrations? No. Okay, well, I just have a few announcements and just to share with you what's happening Wednesday. 10:30, we'll be gathering here at St. Stephen's for a Bible study if you'd like to come join us. And at 5:30, soup supper, 6:30, worship. Ooh, I believe you're going to hear about Rahab. Week. That's another spicy one. If you thought Tamar was spicy, Rahab's got that one hands down. Jen, do you have some announcements to share?
I do. Since you missed the slide this morning because I was late, a few things on the slide just to remind everybody that high schoolers, there is no Monday morning check-in for the rest of this month because we are having tonight Sunday night movies and more. So tonight at 7 o'clock, high schoolers, come on over. I got a good movie. It's an old one. Old favorite that I know you guys haven't seen, but we'll watch the movie, have a little discussion, some snacks, and then play a little fun card game afterwards. So 7 o'clock right here at St. Stephen's High Schoolers. And then also, confirmation class students, I need to get the counts in for camp. So if you know a confirmation student and you know they are wanting to go to camp, I need to get that in so that we can get that our numbers in for a confirmation camp this summer. So, and also, if anybody knows how to get a hold of Ben Ricewick, not Liz who lives across the street, but anybody know Bonnie, I hope you're helping me out on this, maybe to get a hold of Mr. Ben Ricewick. I have one, I'm sure y'all did not hear the sign, but I have one grand prize winner of the silent auction, the hotel stay, and he bid on it, and I lost the slip with his phone number. So, I know that shocks you all, but paperwork has always been my forte, right behind travel and cooking. But I need to get a hold of this man because I'm pretty sure it is his bid and he's the winner. I do not know his phone number. So,
what's his first name?
I don't know that either.
Earl.
Okay, there it is. So, thank you if anybody can help me.
Thank you, Jen. Are there other announcements that need to be shared? Judy, what do you have?
There will not be a women and men's meeting today. We're going to reschedule in 2 weeks.
That sounds like a very wise decision. All right, other announcements? Okay, then, let us present our offerings to God. Thank you. Please rise as you are able to sing the offertory. Let us pray. God of good gifts, receive these and all of our offerings as we present them in faithful service for the sake of your gospel. Prepare our hearts to receive you in this meal as you pour out your very presence through Jesus Christ, the wellspring of eternal life. Amen. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." And now, Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Come and receive Jesus, our strength in the wilderness. The congregation may be seated. And would the communion assistants please come forward?
I'm not sure of that.
Body of Christ, give me the body of Christ.
Divided over things that are not your heart. Spirit, come show us the way. Oh, hallelujah, Christ is with us. In him we live and move and breathe. So with this breath inside our lungs now and forever we will sing. Hey! We will sing and we will stay. Father, we come for forgiveness. We have surrendered our day, turning brothers and sisters to enemies. Jesus, we need your grace. Oh, hallelujah, Christ is with us. In him we live and move and breathe. So with his breath inside, your love unites us, Lord. Oh, what can separate us from your love unites us? Your love unites us, Lord. Oh, what can separate us from your love unites us? Your love unites us, Lord. Oh, what can separate us from your love unites us. Your love unites us, Lord. Oh, can separate us from your love. Oh, hallelujah, Christ is with us. In him we live and move and breathe. So
now may the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen us and keep us in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. May our receiving of Christ's body and blood enter into every fiber of our being. May it transform us more fully into the hands and feet of Christ this day, as we participate in the healing of the world and every body and soul within it. May we depart from this table strengthened to be vessels of God's Spirit. May God's saving work be incarnated in our witness so that others may be invited to find their place and welcome at the table as well. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And now receive the final blessing. God, the giver of love, Christ, the resurrection and the life, and the Holy Spirit of rebirth, bless you on this Lenten journey. Amen. You may remain seated for our closing song.